It's straightforward enough. See, record. Yeah. Top left, it's recorded. If you want to pause at any stage, you
well, hang on.
First thing, when you obviously get to your pitch, yeah, obviously you need to get the caravan onto the pitch. So, using your car, obviously reversing, how good are you on reversing?
Pretty good.
Yeah,
very
good. Yeah, you had towed trailers before?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Right, so, get the caravan on the pitch, check to see if it's level side to side first. So, if it isn't, you're going to need to level it up. Most pitches you go into, which are hard standing, tend to be level side to side. If the grass, obviously, it can be uneven. So if you do need to level it side to side, you're going to need your car to manoeuvre it up onto either blocks, you can get wooden blocks, or there's plastic ramps you can get. Okay, so you can just drive it up the ramp. So using your car to drive it up the ramp. So if it's down on one side, just drive it up, levels it. Okay, spirit level would be useful. Yeah. So it'll give you a more accurate level on it. The reason why we level a caravan is because, one, the drains. Okay, so if you've got the sink drain on this side of the sink and you're leaning that way, the water's just going to be sitting in the sink that side.
Yeah.
Okay, so if it's level, hopefully it will go out after that wiggle. The other thing is the fridge, which runs on gas, doesn't like being on an angle. So it will doesn't make it work very well. So that's the other reason why you need to get level. So once we've got it leveled side to side, or if you need to level it side to side, then we can take the car off. So the first thing you need to do is put the handbrake on. Okay, yeah, which is that there. We'll save the car. Wind it off. I'll show you how to, if you tilt trailers, it's always very straightforward, as in how to get it on and off. But obviously wind it off the car, make sure you disconnect the breakaway cable and your electrics before you move off, otherwise you'll be dragging them with you. Then get the car out of the way. Then you can level it front to back, okay? Use your jockey wheel.
Yeah.
Lower it or heighten it as such to see, using your spirit level to make sure it is level. Excuse me. Okay, you're happy?
Yeah.
So far?
Yeah.
Right, so once we got it level, we can then put the legs down, okay? The legs are not there for lifting it, so if you think you're going to shortcut it by lifting them legs up to lift it, to put the block under the wheel to level it, don't do that, because it can put a lot of stress under the chassis. They're not there to support the whole weight of the caravan, they're just there when you're in it, stopping it bouncing about. Okay? So to do that is you've got four legs all together, so one on the side at the front,
yeah.
Two at the back. I'm just trying to see where the handle is. So you wind the handle. What we've got is a drill. So if you've got a cordless drill at home, you can buy things like that.
Extended
so bike. It makes obviously your life a lot easier.
Yeah.
You see when you can see the clouds coming like they are behind us. So all you do is wind it down. If you do it by drill, obviously a lot quicker. But just all you do is wind it down to the ground. Quite a while, isn't it? Okay,
yeah.
So once it's touching the ground, do the same in all four. And what I need to do is that. Okay, you see there's still a bit of movement. So just half a turn again. So go around into one, half a turn again until it's solid. Okay, so once we've leveled it, got the legs down, then we can start connecting things to it. See, just be careful if you track the boom landing. So. Okay, I'm just putting this back up for it ease up when we hook up later on. Okay. Right, so next thing, as I said, we need to start connecting all the different things. So your gas would already be in there. We're looking at that before you have to. So all you do is just turn your gas on. Go for the acrol. I don't know if the kids are capable of going to fill your water. So give them certain jobs if you can. Okay, so you fill the Aquarol up. Obviously you've got your brand new one in your pack.
Yeah.
This is your water pump, or water pipe I should say. The water pump is actually on board.
Yeah.
So that will draw water up there into your bag. So this is yours. To get it in, it just clicks in. To get it out, just pull back on that trigger there and just release it in. Okay? That's ready, that's good time. Right, so once you've got that in, your battery, I've got a new battery there, I'll fit that. Your battery will already be fitted in there, okay? So most of the time you're just going to be there with the battery in, you're not going to be taking it out, or you shouldn't need to. Okay, electric, this is where you plug your electric in. Now you've got your cable there, so always plug in the cable into your caravan first, then fully unravel it and plug it into the bollard on site.
Yeah.
Okay, if you do it the other way around, plug into the bollard first, you've got a cable
It's likely to, may give you a shock if you're walking across wet grass. So always put it in the caravan first, unravel it, then into bollard. Okay? As I said, your battery is normally inside there. So we've just got this for ease of use. So position your cable there and that lock your door.
Yeah.
So once you've put it in. Okay? You have also got a TV aerial point there as well. So if you've got an external aerial or satellite, you can plug that in there. Okay?
Yeah.
Happy with that bit?
Yeah.
Good. Right, wastewater. Obviously we've got a bucket there just to collect any water that's coming out. So what you'll have is a grey pipe. It's got two outlets down to a single. Piece. So you have the two pipes, they just push into the side of your van that, where that bucket is.
Yeah.
That you can attach all together to stay in one piece. Then that end will go into your waste master, which is that one there.
Yep.
Okay. So that will collect all your wastewater from your sink, your shower, or your two sinks, the kitchen sink, the bathroom sink, and your shower will all come out then through there.
Yeah.
Okay? Normally you'll find once you've entered your acrol, so if you realise you're going to have to go and top that up, the likelihood is that is full as well.
Yeah.
So just make sure that if you are going to fill that up, just check that to see if that's full. You see the shape of the waste master, it's kind of a wedge shape, or L shape I should say. It could slide underneath the van if you wanted to. The only problem is the thin end is where the handle is.
Yeah.
If you push that under the van, how are you going to drag? It's 38 litres of water in there, that's 38 kilo.
Yeah.
You try and drag that back from underneath the van, it's quite tricky. But the best, I just leave it down the side like that. You can see on the box on the side there.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Right, next thing, always a fun bit, toilet.
Yeah.
Okay, so up here is your reservoir for your flush system, okay, which is operated with a 12-volt pump.
Yeah.
So all you do with that is top that up with a small amount of pink chemical and top it with water. I'll just get the key, I'll just show you the... So if you just see that, obviously you can see through the hole, there's nothing to see at the moment.
Yeah.
The only time you know it's full is when you can see the liquid through there. Okay, the only time you know it's empty is when you're flushing it, there's nothing coming out. Okay, so there's no indicator apart from that. But you can have some fluid in there when you're travelling. So if you're obviously with kids, you need to pit stop on the way there, depending on how far you're going. You can pull into the lay line, obviously, not just the kids obviously, you can use the toilet. Don't fill it all the way up for travelling, because if it does overflow, you'll end up with possibly pink chemical whatever, and water inside your van.
Okay.
Just locks there. This is the other fun end. Right, so this is your waste container. It's always nice to go in empty.
Nope.
No, you don't tend to see ladies at the empty point to be quiet. So don't tell him. If he says that you're emptying it, probably some no. Right, to get it out, you can see that, I've just lifted that up there.
Yeah.
That releases it. If it's not coming out easy, the likelihood is that the wastegate on the toilet has been left open or is not fully closed. So if it feels a bit sticky, push it back in, go in, have a look, make sure it is closed.
Yeah.
Then it should release easy. Okay, so before you use it, you need to put blue chemical in there. So you can do that by measuring on the cap. So about, say, half or three quarters of that with around about a pint to a litre of water.
Yeah.
The reason we do that for it, that's to start breaking the nasty stuff down before you empty it later on. Okay, so you do empty it through there as well. So you've got an air release button there, and that will help it to release the lovely stuff down the toilet emptying point. If you've ever been on a campsite before, the toilet emptying point tends to be a big white funnel, a big hole in the centre of it with a brick wall around it.
Yeah.
When you go to empty it, do not put that cap on the brick wall. Because when you're going to empty it, knock that down the hole. You're not sticking around down there, but I wouldn't. Sticking around down there to go and get it back out again. Also, the warden's not going to be too happy because you may have just blocked his sewer. Okay, so the best thing to do is put it on the floor behind you.
Yeah.
Don't put it on there, you knock that down there, you're in trouble. Okay, to clean it, all I tend to do is just put water or whatever in and just slosh it around and flush it out.
Yeah.
Obviously, you can get chemicals to put in there to help clean if you want to. You can access it through that as well. Okay, so you can access it through there as well.
Yeah.
Just make sure that's in that position before you slide it back in. Okay?
Yeah.
Happy with that?
No problem. Yeah.
Just above that, there's this pipe here on the plastic ledge. That pipe is to help drain that. So in the winter, caravans do not like having water in if it's going to freeze.
Yeah.
Obviously, it's not going to be too good if you get frozen pipes. So the best thing to do is flush it. So using your flush, flush it, what's remaining in here, into your tank or another container if you want to keep it and use it again.
Yeah.
Just drain the last little bit with that. Because if you're trying to drain the whole of that tank through there, you're going to be there for a while.
Yeah.
Okay? So, but just make sure you are draining it when you're storing it for winter.
Yeah.
Okay? Okay. The other, excuse me, the other leg points are just at the back here. Okay? So always make sure you put at least one leg down at the back if you're going to be going into the van.
Yeah.
You don't need to get all the legs down if you're just jumping in. If it's attached to the car, obviously that's holding it. So say you're on, as I said, if you're going doing a pit stop in a lay-by or whatever, or service station, you don't need to put the leg down if you've got.
Yes.
Still attached to the car.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
Under one of the bunks. Okay, you see there's a reasonable amount of storage there. Just be very careful you don't put too much weight at the back of the van. Anything behind the axle that's heavy can cause snaking. I don't know if you've heard of that.
Yeah.
Okay, it's obviously important that obviously try and avoid doing that. It's not much fun, I can tell you that now. If you've seen some of the incidents on the motorway and things like that, or heard about. So always put heavy stuff, things like your awning, in the centre of the van, over the axle in the middle of the floor, or slightly forward if anything. Try and keep the light stuff, like bedding or whatever, could go under that space. Doesn't matter when you're on site, because once you're on site, it doesn't matter. You can put as whatever you want to store in and out of there. Okay?
Yep.
Right, another thing which is really important before you start travelling is checking the wheel nuts. Okay? I've got my Torx spanner somewhere, which I will check that before you leave. Okay? But making sure you are checking them before each journey. On your plate here, it does tell you what setting, if you've got a Torx spanner, it does tell you what setting it needs to be, which is 130 newton meters.
Yeah.
Okay, it does tell you the steel setting as well. I can do a steering like that now. Okay, so make sure you are checking, because obviously it's only got two wheels on. You lose one, it's not going to be good. So always make sure you are checking before you go. And you've also got a gas barbecue point there as well.
Okay.
If you are going to use that, obviously don't use it inside the awning.
Yeah.
Because obviously the risk of fire and carbon monoxide. Okay?
Yeah.
Right. Would you like to go inside?